Hi all! Welcome to Truly Wicked Crafts. I'm Truly Wicked. I'm Ava, known as Truly Wicked on Ravelry, and Truly Wicked Crafts on Tumblr, Etsy, Truly Wicked of R on Instagram, and Truly Wicked of Y on Twitter. Everything will be down in the description below. Those of you who watched my last video, I said I'd be back in a week. I wasn't back in a week. Stuff happened, y'all. Stuff happened. Beginning with my chair. You will know I'm in a different location. I'm in a different location because, well, first of all, I wanted to try changing things around, see if I could find a better lighted area. But my chair broke. My desk chair broke. It really broke, people. The squeaky chair. I was sitting in it. It didn't even break, like, at a point where you would expect a break, like someone just sits in it, or I just sit in it. No. My chair decided to break while I was in it. It was like, you know, one of those swiveling desk chairs. And mid-swivel, don't get up on there. Don't you dare. You know better. My cat says hello. This is Kit. But as I was swiveling the desk chair, you know, to turn it to get out from under the desk, I was just about to where I needed to be to stand up. And lo and behold, but what happens? But it breaks. Like, totally breaks. And it didn't break so that I fell out of the chair. No, it had, like, kind of like a cage at the back that wraps around the thighs. And cat butt, sorry y'all. And so I'm secure in there. But it didn't break to the side, so I fell out of the side. It didn't break so that I face planted on the floor. Oh no. No. I turned and I heard a crack and the chair went back. That sucker threw me back. That thing threw me back like I had insulted its mother. But it didn't break so badly that the chair part itself did not separated from the stand that it was on, you know, the post. You know what office chairs and task chairs look like. So that did not completely separate. So I'm there in this, like, little cage of a chair, looking up at the ceiling like, what the hey just happened? And I'm a fluffy girl, y'all. I am a big girl. That's not an easy position for me to get out of. I couldn't roll to the side because of the way the chair was made. It was holding me. I had to call for my mother. Mom, need help. And any of you who remember living with your parents or currently do still live with your parents, because that's what I do. I don't have a significant other. I live with my mother, so I live with my mom. Helps with bills and stuff. Helps. I currently don't have. Anyway, so those of you who, stay off the table. Any of you who still live with your mother or father or parents or remember it, y'all know they make fun of you. Mom comes into that room and she starts laughing. She helps me up, but she starts laughing. And that chair was beyond repair, people. beyond repair. No way were we fixing that sucker. So, I'm not chairless any longer, but it's ugly. The replacement chair came from, there's like a loft space over the welding shop that my granddaddy founded and the family owns, still owns, whatever. There's a loft space, and they use it for storage for everything. Everything. There is stuff in there that has not seen the light of day for years, people. It needs to be cleaned out, but I digress. Well, there was an office chair up there that I liked the feel of. I'm going to put it that way. I liked the feel of it. Not the look, the feel. And so I was like, well, let's just go get that. We had to wait a week to go get it. So, and we've cleaned it up as much as possible. It's an old, old chair. We had to do little jury-rigging repair because the seat back would not stay upright and because of some mechanism beneath. And we managed to jury-rig the mechanism so it worked for me. So now I do have a chair, but I'm still getting used to it, and it's ugly. It is ugly. I'm glad to have it, but it's ugly. It is this funky avocado green, y'all. Avocado green with a vinyl back. I have to be wearing a chair while I'm sitting in this sucker. Otherwise, my back will adhere to the vinyl, which is never a fun happening. Any of you who have gotten the backs of your thighs stuck on vinyl seats, you know this. Ow. Major ow. So we had that issue. And then Granny is back in the hospital. Yeah. Imagine our delight. She was scheduled in for a doctor's appointment, and the night before the doctor's appointment, she just was hurting, her back was hurting her so badly that she called rescue to come get her. So they take her to the hospital, and she's currently still in the hospital, and so far, what we have found out is that there is inflammation, that she had both the severe pain in her back, and my Aunt Marie was giving her extra strength Tylenol because they're afraid that she'll either get addicted to anything stronger, or they being my mother, my aunts, and my uncle, or that she'll take it too much trying to head off the pain. So my Aunt Marie controls the medication. And the reason they're afraid she'll take too much of it to head off the pain is because she was taking excessive doses of aspirin before, and it was starting to affect her hearing. Public service announcement, people. Large doses of aspirin will start making you go deaf. I did not know this. My grandmother, my granny did not know this. Nobody in my family knew this until, lo and behold, doctor says, you've been taking too much aspirin. That's why you can't hear. Really? They kind of need to put that in very large print. Because you know that nobody reads that little itty bitty teeny tiny fine print on an aspirin bottle. They need to put it in big bold letters. Taking too much can cause deafness. That is something that needs to be known. That is a very big side effect. No, wait. There was a comedian a while back. I forget. And I'm probably going to kick myself when I remember. But when something that big happens as a result of a medication you're taking, that's not a side effect. It's not a side effect, that's an effect. Is what the, I think it might have been Robin Williams, but not sure. So, my Aunt Marie was just giving her Tylenol. Well, the doctor told my aunt that when someone's back is hurting them that badly, Tylenol is not going to cut it. Extra strength Tylenol, not going to cut it. Mm-mm. At all. I mean, it's bad enough that the doctor has actually had the nurses giving her morphine. Yeah, my granny's on morphine. It's an interesting experience to talk to Granny when she's on morphine. Just a little, just a bit. Just a teeny tiny little bit. But the doctors, when they checked out her back, when she had the mini discectomy to deal with the slipped disc that she had that was pressing against a nerve, they discovered, let me move this, see if that changes any of the temperature. Apparently not. But they discovered that the inflammation in that particular area had spread to other discs and were causing them to become so inflamed that it was causing more problems. Causing problems with the other discs. We don't need that. We really do not need that, people. So they currently are keeping Granny in the hospital for observation and to try and figure out, you know, how to fix it without surgery. They also want to keep her because of her digestive issues. She's had quite a few. She's either constipated or she has diarrhea, or there are various digestive issues that she has. When she's in the hospital, she eats really well. But when she's not in the hospital, she doesn't eat as much. It's not that she forgets. I think it's just that she doesn't really want to. I think it's that she doesn't really want to get up and have to deal with the pain of her back while she's making herself some food. So she doesn't eat as much. Not to mention when someone is in pain, they don't want to eat. They just want to curl up and sleep. They just want to escape. But, so she's been having digestive issues. But there's something else going on, because when they checked that out, they found out that there's some inflammation. Years ago, my granny had her gallbladder removed. Years ago. And there's like, I don't know if it's a natural tube or whatever, but there's a tube leading from where the gallbladder used to be to the rest of my granny's digestive system, and that's inflamed. So they're trying to figure out how to fix it. So that's where my granny is. And worrying about Granny and dealing with the fallout is kind of where we've been all week. So, first week, chair issues. Second week, holy moly, Granny's in the hospital again. They will be moving her back to St. Catharines for recovery. As soon as it's all figured out. My poor Granny, man. She does not deserve this. So, like I said, busy. But now I'm back. Guess who's back again. Oh Lord, that was bad. Sorry, y'all. So let's get into, you know, what you probably came here for, which is the crochet. Crafting, crochet. It's all been crochet, people. Start with finished objects. I guess this is kind of a partial, these are kind of part, the first two are like kind of partial finished objects, because I'm part of the I'm participating in the Moogly blog. Do not do that. Sorry, cat misbehaving. But I am participating. Kit, stop that. She's trying to dig into the couch like a dog digs. Stop that. You know better. But I'm participating in the Moogly blog 2016 Afghan Along. And I'm actually making two. Yeah, well, clues were released 2 weeks apart. I think I can handle two. Stop that. But, you know, it's part of my 2016 goals to make an Afghan. One is for my mother. And she purchased the yarn for this, so technically... Alright, off the couch, stop digging at it. So technically, she's the one who bought the yarn, so it's... I didn't buy the yarn. I'm not on a yarn band, but I didn't buy the yarn. And it's Red Heart with Love. And as you can see, there are four colors. This is the Flame Square by Jesse at Home. I will link to Moogly Blog's... Excuse me. I will link to Moogly Blog's Afghan Along thing in the description. So, yeah. Purple. Variegated. Oh, it's purple with some little splotches of green. One really, really, really dark purple. A royal purple and green. And, of course, actual green. Solid green. The ends are woven in. They're just not clipped off yet because I don't do that until after I wash the item. I follow the advice of Aaron from Gimme Yarn 418, and I don't clip off the ends until after it's washed. So any like little scooting that the ends want to do among the where it's woven in will not negatively affect. It won't come unraveled. And here's the second square I'm making for me. And it's heathered gray, bluebell, also red art with love. Peacock, black. You will note there's a slight difference between these two. Won't you? I kind of fudged up on the first couple of rounds. Not that it doesn't bother me, but it's like, oh, okay. It'll make it special different. But, so that's the start of doing the Afghan Along, and number two finished object. I made slippers. These are the Cloud 9 slippers. I do not remember who they're by, but super, super, super easy. It's in a number 6 bulky weight, Phoenix something colorway. I made my granny a pair of these, a smaller pair, because she got little feet, for Christmas. This is next year's Christmas gift for somebody. I'm already working on those, people. Oh yes, it shall be done. I have over 30 people to make gifts for. And I'm telling you right here now, if I don't get at least a thank you from the guys in my family this year, this coming Christmas, for their gifts, they aren't getting any more crochet gifts from me. I don't want to be a downer, I don't want to be negative about it, but I'd appreciate at least a thank you. Because you're putting a lot of time and effort and emotion into these gifts for people, and if they don't even thank you, that's just wrong. That is just wrong. And it hurts my feelings. And I don't deal well with hurt feelings. I really don't. So that's all my finished objects. The reason that's all my finished objects is because for most of these 2 weeks, moving on into WIPs. For most of these 2 weeks, I have been working on one thing. Most of these 2 weeks. The reason I say it's for most of these 2 weeks is because, oh lordy, the one thing I have been working on, yeah, I'm pulling it out of my cherry bag, has been, oop, I'm gonna lose the yarn, has been this. You've seen this before. This is the beaded box shawl, much larger than previous. I worked on this like it was going out of style. But then I just now started doing the first round of the border. The border has two rounds. And there's one that's mostly chains and it's a chain. Stop that. This is not kitty toy. It's my cat. Not a kitty toy. But it's, you chain four or five and then you double crochet into the main body of the shawl. That's the first round. I'm not even all the way around it. This is how much yarn I have left, period. I don't have another skein. It only came with five skeins. I got to like the fourth skein and figuring how many skeins I'd done to create how many rows. My brain went, wait a minute. Yeah, this little bit of yarn ain't gonna be enough. Because the second round is the little box stitches. These right here. Those. Yeah. That's the second round. And because that is the second round, it eats up a lot of yarn. It's made up of a chain three, two chain threes, and first part is a chain three, and then four double crochets. Next part, chain three, four double crochets the other way. So, yeah, not enough yarn. So, I am going to have to order more yarn. Just one more skein, I think will cover it. If I can remember what this colorway actually is, because of course I've lost the ball band. But it's a little frustrating because this came in a kit. You'd think if it comes in a kit, it'll have enough yarn to finish it. Five skeins, not enough. Nope. Mm-mm. Sadly, not enough. So that's currently in hibernation until I can get another skein of yarn. But I got that thing almost done in a week. And then it was like, oh no. Next work in progress. Yet another crochet along. This is part of clue one. Possible spoiler here, people, if you're not doing it. Melly's Makings crochet along. Oh. This is clue one finished. I haven't started on clue two yet, even though it came out yesterday. I have not started on clue two yet, just because I haven't had time. Well, no. I could have started on the second clue last night, but I did not. The reason I did not is because I did not have a tape. I was working on it in bed. I was working on stuff in my bed, and I did not have a tape measure in my bed. I need to, like, Notions pouch all over my house, because I'll be sitting somewhere, and I'll need a tape measure or something, and it's like, oh, I don't have it. Darn. But that's my second whip. I have one more, made out of yarn that you will see when I insert a video for my stash enhancement. So I'm not going to tell you what kind of yarn it is yet. You will see. But this is, oh Lord, I don't remember. I do not remember. It's kind of like a French type name, but it's a cowl. It's made out of DK weight yarn. That red is just gorgeous. Gorgeous. And, it's nice yarn, people. In fact, here is where I will pause in our current present state of events and let you see when my box of yarn that I had ordered from Knit Picks came in the mail. Okay, I have a package. It's from Knit Picks. It's one I've been expecting. But I wanted to open it with you guys here because it's some fancy yarn. And I wanted y'all here with me to, you know, see my reaction to how this actually feels as soon as I feel it. Because some of it's got cashmere, and I've never felt yarn with cashmere before, like, ever. So, we are going to discover how I feel about yarn with cashmere before it's knitted up into anything, or blocked, or washed, or anything like that. So, no. You have your little Christmas hint list there. Some other stuff that I got. I got fork blocking pins because I am actually like more than halfway through with the main body of my beaded box shawl right now, and I knew I was going to need blocking pins. I also got some of the Knit Picks brand and T-pins. So, you know. Plenty of pins. Next, of course, comes the yarn. I'm just going to slide it out of the bag. Alright. This is Knit Picks Gloss. I've been wanting some of this for a while. It's 70% merino wool, 30% silk. This is the Kenai. It's pretty. See? Very pretty. I don't know after it's processed if it'll still look that blue. Oh, and that's closer. But it's this marvelous sort of teal color. I mean marvelous. This is pretty. It's not as soft as I was expecting, but I imagine it gets softer once it's washed and blocked. Also in gloss is Winter Night. Ooh, pretty, pretty blue. It looks a little too bright in that photo, but gosh, it is pretty. Okay, next I think I will get out. I got their MCN base, which is merino, which is 80% merino, 10% cashmere, and 10% nylon. I got two colors. I think it's called Capretta. So I'm about to touch it. It is soft. Oh my. And it is squishy. It is squishy. Wow. Okay, I think I see why people are a little very into, like, cashmere blends, because, yeah, this is soft. I might actually be able to make my mother something out of this one, which is why I got this. This is the Regal colorway. And I also got it in Celestial. Kit, get off. My cat's, like, going behind the camera. She's kind of worrying me. Fuzzball, stop. That looks majorly bright in the camera. It's not that bright, but yeah, pretty, pretty blue. And then I actually got onto Knit Picks in order to order the pins. Yeah, I went on Knit Picks to order my blocking pins. But then, of course, they have, you know, $50 order, you get free shipping. So, I went, I think I'll get some yarn to round it out to the free shipping. Which is usually the opposite of how it works. Usually, you know, you go on to get yarn and you wind up getting a bunch of other stuff. But, to round it out, because I didn't want to get a bunch more little balls of whatever. I got their Diadem DK. Because I don't actually have any DK yarn, DK weight yarn, and I was like, well, it looks pretty impressive, might as well check it out, might as well see what I can do with it, see how it feels, and it's 50% baby alpaca, 50% mulberry silk, it's 100 grams, and it's red, it's glossy, it's shiny. I haven't actually touched it yet. I'm just, like, looking at the tag. And it's a single ply, so let's see. Wowza. Holy moly. Oh my. Oh. Ooh. Okay, yeah, it's a single ply, and it is going to be mine. This is going to make something for me. No one else is getting... Wow. Oh, wow. If I were to actually make this into something that I gave to somebody else, which usually that's most of what I do, but this feels so flippin' amazing. I mean, whoa. So if, like I said, normally I make stuff and I give it to other people. But I don't know. I don't think there's any way I'd make this into something for someone else. This feels so, so good. That I am actually imagining it. I'm very much a texture, you know, starts with a W. So, whoo, wowie, whoa. Okay, I can definitely see why the Diadem is like 14 to $17. That is impressive, people. That is majorly, majorly impressive. That is, wow. Huh. Yeah. I'm speechless with, I was not expecting to be that impressed. I really wasn't, but I am. So yeah, there you go. There's the whole. There's the sum of my yarn buying. So thank you for joining me on it. And watching my selfish gushing as soon as I touched the Diadem, which was supposed to be just to round it out, but my God. So yeah, I had a little greedy me moment there. If I have any yarn left over after I'm finished making the cowl, which I'm sure I will, but if I have any yarn left over, I'm probably going to make a little stuffy for somebody who I will not say who, because it will be a surprise. But I was talking to my friend in Sweden, Ash, and about my yarn arriving, because I hear so much about cashmere, and I was expecting the cashmere blend to be like, oh my god, bunny soft. I was expecting the cashmere to be the most amazing feeling yarn, like, ever. I hear about it so much. I was a little underwhelmed. It probably feels a lot softer, you know, once it's crocheted or knit up, and then soaked and blocked. Probably feels a lot softer or a lot more amazing. But as I told my friend Ash, the diadem feels like a baby unicorn. It feels like petting a baby unicorn, people. It is that magical. It is that magical. So, I was like, yeah, keeping. I don't make quite so much for me. The hat I'm actually wearing right now, which I did make, it's a previous finished object. I think I showed it to you, like, in the first episode. But the hat I'm wearing is not technically for me. I'm currently wearing it, but it has not yet found its home. I don't know if I'm going to give it to a family member or charity or whatever. But it currently lives, like, in my finished items bag, and the only reason I'm wearing it is because I'm having a bad hair day. And I can't find any of the hats I made for myself. The hat made out of the alpaca dance, the fanny hat. I can't find it anywhere. I organized my room as well as I could with, like, just one shelf. I only have one shelf, people. It's not a good state of affairs. With the amount of yarn I've got, it's not too much yarn, but comparatively, it is not too much yarn. But, you know, I don't have enough storage. I need to get more storage, but right now we are getting our storage, like, finding shelves that people have left out on the side of the road. We try to go for free as much as possible, people. So, yeah, I don't know where my alpaca dance hat is. Most of my stuff is in boxes. I don't want my yarn, and I don't want my finished objects to be in boxes. Because the wool moths and other pests that like to nest in yarn, they don't like light. They're not fans of light. So I want my yarn out. I want it in the open. Free the yarn, people. Free the yarn. So, I'm going to see if I can, you know, find other shelving. And then reorganize so I can find my hat. So that's it for whips, finished objects, and acquisitions, fed stash. What else? I have no entertainment gushing at all. None. Nada. Zip. I intended to do that. Although, I guess technically you could call talking about new podcasts new. Yeah, kind of new. Podcasts, entertainment gushing. For a while now, I have been watching the Crafting with Claudie podcast. And after weeks of this, after watching her and enjoying her, because she's cute. She's adorable, people. She's really sweet, and I just love the way she talks. And her voice is very soothing. And so I finally commented because she wanted people to comment on her Crafty Goals video with what their crafty goals were and if they had a video to give her the link. So I did. I don't actually often do that. I don't actually often tell the people that I watch that, oh, hey, I have a vlog too. Want to check it out? I don't. I'm really shy about that. I don't want to feel like I'm, you know, I feel like I'm annoying if I do that. But hey, if you ask for my Crafty Goals video, here! So yeah, I finally talked to her and joined her Ravelry group. I think I did, or I don't know if I remembered to actually click the little join button. I put it in my bookmarks because it was late at night. But then I looked in my like little YouTube notifications, I found it, and I saw that she subscribed to me. So hi! Hello. And the other podcast, this one is a new one. I found this podcast like 2 days ago. I have been binge watching. No, not 2 days ago. Last night. Now, I found it last night. I binge watched to like the middle of episode 11 of the Forest Home Fiber Arts podcast. Did I get that right? I probably did not get that right. It will be in the description, people. It will be in the description. But she's a crocheter. She's fun. She's so much fun. If you crochet or if you like hearing about crochet, watching crochet. Well, she doesn't actually crochet on screen, but if you like seeing Afghans and doilies, people, she does doilies. I love it. I don't do doilies yet. I have a plan for making a filet crochet unicorn doily at some point in the future. Not sure when, but it will happen because my mother is super into unicorns. So I love hearing her talk about them because I remember doilies. I remember the doilies. My granny still uses doilies. She puts her lamps on top of them, uses them to protect her side tables from scratches, that kind of thing. And she's the one who made them. But she didn't. Here's the thing. Granny never made her doilies, did not make her doilies when she made them out of, you know, commercially available crochet thread. Because Granny grew up out in the country. She grew out on a farm. On a tobacco farm. So what did she use? She used tobacco twine. Yeah. My granny used tobacco twine for her doilies. It's fantastic. I love it. I love it. And I love seeing someone else talk about these things. Because you hardly hear about it. I mean, there's a lot of amazing crochet out there. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful crochet. But so few people talk about doilies. And it's nice to hear somebody talking about doilies. And talking about Afghans. Most people, when they're talking about their Afghans, they're like, oh, yeah, it's this big, huge project that I have to get through. She doesn't. Her name is Molly. And she doesn't. You can tell she enjoys making these things. She's always excited about them. So it's always really fun to watch. And she has the cutest names for her sections. And I'm just loving watching her. She is wonderfully fun. So, she's got like a section where she brings out like cherished objects. And I had wanted to bring one of mine out. But of course, I'm getting my stuff together and I forget because today I do not have notes. I need to get back into the habit of doing notes. But I don't know. I didn't tell her when I commented on one of her videos that I have a vlog. I don't call it a podcast. I want to call it a podcast, but it's not on iTunes, so I can't call it a podcast. At least in my brain. I'll probably eventually fall into calling it a podcast, but not right now. But I didn't tell her that I have a vlog on YouTube. So I don't know if she'll check me out on her own or whatever. If she does and she sees this, hi, Miss Molly. People go watch her. Again, I will link in the description. She's so much fun and her kids are adorable. Her kids are adorable. Even when that, you can tell they're driving her just a teeny tiny bit crazy. As children do. Because my mother, trust me, my mother has told me I drove her insane as a child. I probably still drive her insane. Probably. Probably. But she... But yeah, her kids are adorable. And she's just such a good mama. You can tell. She's just such a good mama. She's very good at, like, not losing her patience, I think. And her travails with the puppies. Oh, God. Her travails with those puppies. They have chewed on probably every crochet thing. Everything related to crochet anywhere around, probably. They've chewed on hooks. They've chewed on afghans. They have chewed on a project basket. Eek. Oh, Lord knows when... Do you hear my cat? What? What is it? What do you want? You have food. You have water. What are you fussing about? Shush. No, no, no! Earthquake! Sorry! Kit! Come here, you twit. Apparently, she wanted attention.
Bad kitty.
So, speaking of animals and podcasting, but yeah, her miniature Australian Shepherds are adorable, but you know they drive her crazy. And it's fun to watch, and just watching her, and I hope she doesn't consider this an insult or anything, but watching her and just her general attitude makes me think, I'm gonna have a bit of a fandom moment here, people, but she reminds me of Molly Weasley. She reminds me of Molly Weasley, not from the Harry Potter movies, but from the books. Just the sense of such a loving, generous personality that you get from watching her. And it just... Anybody who knows me knows that knows that Molly Weasley is like one of my favorite characters from the Harry Potter franchise. She's not my top favorite character, but that's because I identified more strongly with Hermione. But Molly Weasley is like up there, and she reminds me of Molly Weasley in just how, I repeat, how loving you can tell she is just by watching. Just the energy in her podcasts. And it's just, It's lovely. Sorry, messing with the bill of the hat. Probably should not do that. And her love affair, she calls it, with Cotton. With Peaches and Cream, before it was sold to the same people who work with Lily, Sugar and Cream, is fantastic. I wish I could get my hands on some of those colors. Oh my god. And I don't know how Peaches and Cream used to feel, because I only started crocheting a year ago. Literally a year ago. This is not like the anniversary of when I started crocheting, but I started crocheting in January 2015. So it's been a year of me crocheting. Oh my god. So I started off with Cotton Yarns. And I get, because it's at Walmart. Peaches and Cream, as it is now, is at Walmart. But I've never touched, never gotten my hands on any of the Peaches and Cream before Lily, Sugar and Cream started putting it out. So I have no idea, absolutely no idea, what it used to feel like. And I've heard from a lot of people that it used to feel really good. I don't like working with it much anymore because Peaches and Cream feels a little rough before it's been washed and everything, because this is like made mostly out of Peaches and Cream, and after it's washed for the first time, it does feel really nice. It does feel really nice after it's washed, but actually working with the yarn, I wish I could say I really love it. But with Peaches and Cream, I don't really love working with it because it's really rough on my hands. I feel the same way about Lily, Sugar and Cream. So I've heard that before Lily, Sugar and Cream took over Peaches and Cream, that it was softer and it felt better to work with. I'm a little envious, Miss Molly. I'm a little envious that you have Peaches and Cream to work with from before the advent of Lily, Sugar and Cream taking it over. But I do like working with cotton yarns. I love Hobby Lobby's. I love this cotton. That is superiorly soft. That is wonderfully soft. For a cotton, people. So, I do like working with cotton. I just prefer working with cottons that are not as rough as Lily, Sugar and Cream, and Peaches and Cream as it is currently. Now, that's not to say I don't have like a ton and a half of Peaches and Cream. I do. I have quite a bit. Eventually, once I get my craft area, because all my stuff is in my room. But eventually, when I get all my craft stuff, arranged and organized, I will flash my stash. So you can see what all I have. It's quite a bit. I mean, there's no way it'll take up, all of my room. Because I don't have the budget to buy a bunch of yarn. Mom and I only got yarn for, the afghans. We only got one skein of each color. And, two of the skeins for mine were, already in my stash. Partially used, but still. Not like yarn goes bad or anything. If you like crochet anything, if you like doilies, people, watch Forest Home Fiber Arts podcast. Do it. Do it, do it, do it, do it. You gotta. You will love it.
Okay. Check that out.
I do believe that's us done for today, since I don't have my cherished object. Yeah. Bad me. Well, I guess maybe I do. She's not an object, but the cat. The cat qualifies. She's 13 years old, people. She is an old kitty. And she, as you can tell, since she's not trying to squirm away. Well, now she did. Because I let my arm relax. She's a lap kitty. I will... She's a nervous lap kitty. Sorry about the kitty, but she's a nervous lap kitty. My poor fuzzball. Like, these past couple of years, she's overgroomed around her tail and on her back flanks. And it's bald. It's just this little fuzz of hair. It's very fine fuzz over that area now. And sometimes, and she'll go through cycles where she does and she doesn't. She used to do it so badly she gave herself sores. She no longer does that, but it's just this patchy little forest of fuzz. Quit showing them your rear end. Furball. So, I love her. She's, as all pets can be, frustrating. But I love her. So, we'll consider her the cherished thing. Thing covers it. A person or an animal is a thing. Yes, people are things. A thing is an all-purpose noun, in my opinion. Describes both living and non-living things. See? Things. People are things. So, next vlog, I will bring what I had originally planned to bring, because next vlog, I will have notes. I will have notes, people. Hopefully, I will also have more finished objects, but so, thank you for watching. Please comment, like, subscribe if you enjoyed me. Let me know if you enjoyed me. Let me know if there's anything you'd rather see or rather not see. Let me know if there's anything you think that I can do to improve. Please, 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 please. Share if you think other people will like me, okay? If you think there are other people out there who will enjoy my particular brand of babbling, share with them. Please, just, you know, let me know what you think. So, I will skittle on out of here. I already said thank you for joining me, didn't I? I always forget that. I always forget whether I said thank you or not. Or sometimes I don't forget and I do it anyway. I say it again. Take care of yourselves until next we meet. Bye, y'all.